Part 1 of 3. Hear, O Israel. These words promised to Israel and then out to the whole world, bringing in the new era, connecting prophecy, aligning in the truth of the living Word of God. And the mysteries revealed today, clear as glass, to see through into the marvelous light of the perfect will of God. To this generation of promise, this is the beginning of Israel's golden age. Hear these words as Scripture aligns unto Israel being the throne of the Lord of hosts, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the Holy One of Israel getting all the glory in all of this. Hallelujah! As we rejoice in these words, let us hear and pray for deep spiritual understanding into these words. Finally, these words are here, being the keys to all Israel was intended to be through Messiah, through His words, and unto the Lord God ever since being freed from Egypt. The time is here for clarity, truth of the will of the Lord for all of His people, His holy nation. Since the days of Joshua, son of Moses, when he entered into the promised land ready for the new beginning, all those thousands of years ago, yet only seen war his whole life and still never stopped to wonder why. Since the beginning of the faith of Abraham, being an outsider, becoming a Hebrew man of God, then blessed with descendants, as many as the stars in the heavens, all because of his faith, proving that faith was all we needed. Since the time of Jacob, having 12 sons, becoming the 12 tribes of Israel. Since David, the man after God's own heart, that prevailed because of his true love back to God. Throughout the generations, much success and blessing within the history of Israel, yet also much failure from the very people that claimed to be his holy people. Much good, yet much disappointment, hurt, and loss. Not because it was the will of God, but because of stiff necks and hard hearts living in the flesh rather than the Spirit of God. Yet now Israel has been gathered for such a time as this in history for things to change. The new covenant to live in as prophecy has stated in Jeremiah 31:31-35. Behold, the time is here, declares the Lord, for a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand and led them out of the land of Egypt, being a covenant they broke, though I was a husband to them. But this is the new covenant I have established with the whole house of Israel and with the house of Judah, declares the Lord of hosts. I will now put my laws in their minds instead of phylacteries and inscribe it on their hearts instead of a scroll. I will be their God and they will be my people. No longer will each man teach his neighbor or his brother, saying, Know the Lord, because they will all know the Lord, from the least of them to the greatest, declares the Lord God of Israel. For I will forgive their sins, and I will remember their sins no more. Thus says the Lord, who gives the sun for light by day, and who sets in order the moon and the stars for the light at night, who stirs up the sea so that its waves roar. The Lord of hosts is his name. We serve a God of promise, as the alignment of the void and confusion and segregation now instead coming to unity and completion. To the house of Israel and to all of its inhabitants, God did not send Messiah into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him, and that the world be at peace in truth of the perfect will of God. Though within the new covenant, Judah is not what you would expect. Remember, God always surprises us in the stories of his doings. From the Israelites thinking that they were at the dead end, but then were surprised to see the oceans part so that they may walk through safely. Or like Jonah being upset at God for not destroying Nineveh because Jonah warned them, but it didn't happen. Yet it was because they repented in sackcloth with a true full heart of repentance. God then had mercy on them. You see, we serve a God of promise, but also a God of mystery, surprise, and mercy as well as wrath. In the same way, within the new covenant promised is now not only for the Jews this time, but also to all nations being grafted in as well. Isaiah 49:6. It is too small of a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the preserved ones of Israel. I will also give you as a light to the Gentiles, the non-Jews as well, that you should be my salvation unto the ends of the earth. Because of this truth of prophecy, Judah is now consisting of those from other nations that were originally not a part of the houses of Israel, that will join to praise the Lord and obey His word in spirit and in truth, along with the whole house of Israel. To all of those that hear this truth and believe in the light of the world, accept His words in, and remember to welcome the Gentiles to unite with open arms. They are grafted into Judah, since Messiah is in Judah, and He welcomes those from His flock that hear His words and begin to serve the God of Israel, as this is what will bring harmony into all of His people within His holy nation. Jeremiah 3:17-18. At that time they shall call Jerusalem the throne of the Lord, and the nations shall all be gathered unto it, to the name of the Lord, to Jerusalem. Neither shall they walk any more after the stubbornness of their evil hearts. In these days the house of Judah will walk with the house of Israel, and they will come together in the land that I have given to them as an inheritance unto my people, my holy nation, says the Lord of hosts. As you might already know, Messiah is from the line of David, and that is Judah. So therefore, what you might not know is this means that the Gentile non-Jews that believe in Him are now also welcomed into Judah and will gather in Jerusalem to the throne of the Lord to learn, to sing, to dance, and to rejoice, because God is doing a miraculous new thing. Genesis 49:10. The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor the student of the law from between his feet, and to him will be the obedience of peoples. This is the beginning of a beautiful harvest of a marvelous light for the whole world to witness, that he that believes in Messiah is not condemned, but he that does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed on the name of the only true Messiah to come to this world. When he is revealed to you, believe. Truth is the living word of God. It's not about who is wrong or right. It's about the words of God in truth and in light. We do not live on bread alone, but by every word that the Lord God has spoken. In His word is salvation, and Messiah is the living word of God in the flesh, the promised word of God within the new covenant as promised to His people. Deuteronomy 18:15. Moses said, "The Lord our God will raise up for you a man like me from amongst you, from your fellow Israelites. You must listen to him, for this is what you asked of the Lord our God at Horeb, on the day of the great assembly, when you said, 'Let us not hear the voice of the Lord our God, nor see his great fire anymore, or we will die.' As they were very frightened from his powerful voice, the Lord God answered his people when he said, 'What they say is good. I will raise up for them a man like Moses from among your fellow Israelite descendants, and I will put my words in his mouth. He will tell them everything I command him. I myself will call account to anyone who does not listen to my words that he speaks in my name.'" Because of these words from God, hear, O Israel. To those that don't believe, the condemnation is this, that the light has come into the world, and many loved darkness rather than the light, because their works were evil, and that is why they don't believe. But those that belong to God will hear and believe and obey these teachings and praise Him in the light of dawn. Everyone that does evil hates the light and does not come to the light, or else their evil deeds would be exposed. Those that live in the truth comes to the light, that their works may be seen clearly that they have been done in God, in spirit and in truth. Everyone that drinks of the water on earth will thirst again and again, but whoever drinks the water that Messiah gives them will never thirst. Spiritually speaking, the pure water that Messiah gives is from God. It is the Spirit of God, and within His Spirit becomes in you a fountain of living water springing up to eternal life. Isaiah 44:3. I will pour out water on the thirsty land and streams on the dry ground. I will pour out my spirit on your offspring and my blessings on your descendants. Therefore, learn instead of teach when the words of Messiah are present. Cherish them like you have cherished the Holy Torah all of these years. For the words of Messiah is the new covenant, and all that believe in the only true Messiah sent by God will be a part of the new covenant promised in Jeremiah 31:31 through 40, as mentioned earlier. Israel has been hurting for centuries because of its rebellion and disobedient hearts, stiff-necked, following the wrong oral Torah and traditions passed down by men of false pretense with religious traditions rather than the truth, placing heavy burdens upon the people of God. Reminder, they are not the Messiah, so stop following them. It's time for a new, through the words of Messiah, for even Moses and David were overjoyed for the time of Messiah to arrive. The hour comes, and now is, when the holy nation of God will worship Him in spirit and in truth all together. For in spirit, because the remnant of God will be no longer satisfying the flesh, but instead in full obedience to God, with all of their hearts because of beginning to trust God like never before, with all their soul, mind, and spiritually, and in truth because of the word of the Lord, will be living amongst His holy nation. No more is the past like your ancestors that were cursed and scattered, but instead in the days of Messiah being revealed in Israel in a way of clarity in the light of God. That is why you are gathered now, for such a time as this of change in Israel. Though there will be many that don't believe in the name of Messiah, and they will be cut off from the land and from the kingdom of God, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth in eternal deep darkness. This horrible thing will happen because of their disbelief, but see, it has been warned to you ahead of time. Those that obey God, not for religious traditions of man, but instead with all of their heart, with passion and zeal, loving God back for His promises, being honored, His true love, and His grace given to you for sending the promised Messiah. We serve a promise-keeping God. He is spirit. And they that worship the Lord of hosts must do it in spirit and in truth. Just as the trees of the earth obey and give fruit in due season, so will the remnant of God be in these days of the great harvest, the seed now planted and will sprout beautiful fruit in due season. God is your true King, O Israel. Psalms 29:10, the Lord sits enthroned over the mighty flood. The Lord is enthroned as King forever. He is the eternal King. He is restoring Israel to be a splendor to all nations, the new Jerusalem in the glory of His marvelous light. The hour comes and is now close at hand when the dead shall hear the voice of the Lord and will rise from the dust of the ground. He that hears these words and believes on Him that He has sent and puts these words into practice has eternal life and will not go into everlasting condemnation, but instead has passed out of death into life. Daniel 12:2. Those who sleep in the dust of the earth will awake, some to everlasting life and others to shame and everlasting condemnation. Messiah says, "You search the scriptures because you think that in them you have eternal life." These are the same scriptures that say to listen to the words of Messiah when the words are present. So listen and hear, O you lost sheep. Deuteronomy 18:15, I myself will call account to anyone who does not listen to my words that he speaks in my name. Though if you believe not in the words of Moses, how will you believe in the words of Messiah? Therefore, listen to this scripture, a truth that gathers together and causes Israel to be its greatest potential for all the world to see its splendor. Do not have hard hearts and stiff necks like your ancestors. Pray for a soft heart to feel and ears to hear truth spiritually so that you can be renewed. Don't work for the food that perishes, but instead for the food that abides to eternal life. Murmur not amongst yourselves. Messiah is the bread of life because His words come from God, and that is more important than even the bread you eat. Deuteronomy 8:3. He humbled you, causing you to hunger, and feeding you with manna, which neither you nor your ancestors have known, to teach you that man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. This is why we must trust in Him fully, to know that He knows best for all, and that is why we put our full trust of our lives in Him and pray often for guidance. The spirit is that which makes alive. The flesh profits nothing. The words the Messiah speaks is spirit and is life. The teachings that you will hear from Messiah are from God, and that is why his teachings and the Old Testament Tanakh will all align. Though remember to trust God instead of thinking that all prophecy happens at once. In the same way, when you see the signs of a fig tree, when its branch gets tender and its leaves begin to show, you know that summer is near. And in the same way, you know that this time is here, at the door. The true gospel being preached to the entire world is a witness, and then the end will come shortly after that. So hear truth and believe, for these words cry out truth among the hills of Judea, on the heights of the holy mountain, also upon all the surrounding inhabitants, now also out to the whole world. He that speaks of himself seeks his own glory, but he that seeks the glory of him that sent him, he is true, and unrighteousness is not in him, for he has humbled himself to speak truth beyond himself. So therefore, judge not according to appearance, but rather, judge with righteous judgment only. Messiah is the light of the world. He that follows him shall not walk in darkness, but instead will have the light of life. Not because of himself, but because of the word that he speaks is from God. And those that live in the word of God are walking in the light and become the light of the world. If you abide in the words of God, the Old Testament Bible, combined with the words of Messiah, then you shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free, as it all aligns together like puzzle pieces that connect. Everyone that sins is a servant of sin. Therefore, the truth will make you free. Those that belong to God will hear the words of God. For this reason, if you do not hear, then you are not of God. Anyone whom keeps these words will never see death, for death is a lie. And we live eternal in salvation of God. Therefore, it is said to you now, if anyone keeps and seeks these words, he will never taste death. Messiah is the door to the kingdom, because he is the true word of God in the flesh, being the true shepherd, as was prophesied from many prophets within the Old Testament. Through Messiah, if any person enter in, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. Though these words have come so that you may have life and have it more abundantly. Messiah is the good shepherd. The good shepherd would lay down his life for the sheep. Therefore, the Messiah is the good shepherd. Also, he is a good shepherd to another sheepfold that isn't of this fold. Them also he must bring into the kingdom through Judah, combining into the whole house of Israel as one to serve the Lord. All together they will say, "Our God is one." There shall be one flock when they unite, and one shepherd. Judah and the house of Israel will unite. Though if you believe not, it's because you are not of the sheepfold at all. Hosea 1:11. The people of Judah and the people of Israel will come together. They will appoint one leader and will come up out of the land, for great will be the day of Jezreel. What Messiah is doing now you know not, but you will know after this. Though unless you are washed, you will have no part with Messiah. This is why you must fulfill righteousness in water and in spirit, as all the remnant of people of God will obey and do this. Ezekiel 36:25. I will sprinkle clean water on you, and you will be clean. I will cleanse you from all your impurities and from all your idols. Isaiah 1:16, wash and make yourselves clean. Take your evil deeds out of my sight and stop doing wrong. Ruth 3:3, wash yourself and anoint yourself and put on your best clothes. Water is essential for cleansing, just as the words of Messiah is essential for truth and a spiritual life, as you would need to be in the joy of being renewed and being born again. Remember, in the same way an employee is not greater than his manager, nor is a manager greater than he that sent him. If you know these things, then blessed are you. He that receives these words receives Messiah that sent them. And he that receives Messiah receives God that sent him. The love you show for one another, and the love you show for the oppressed, for the widows, for the orphans, and for the poor, shows that you truly belong to God. Always stand for justice and equality for all people. Psalms 146, 7 through 10. He upholds the cause of the oppressed and gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets prisoners free. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the foreigners and sustains the orphans and the widows, but he frustrates the ways of the wicked. The Lord reigns forever. O sons and daughters of Zion, praise and exalt the Lord of hosts, our holy majestic God, who is full of justice and steadfast goodness. If you love the Lord your God, then you will keep these words that are sent out to the world from Jerusalem, and you will follow your example. Our example is Messiah. As he said, God cares for the needy, so you should also. By obeying these words in return, the heavy burden will finally be lifted off of you, and also God will give you a gift, his Spirit, that will dwell with you always, that he will be with you forever, giving you spiritual understanding, helping you within your walk of faith, your spiritual maturity, the Spirit of truth. Those not of God will not know the Spirit of God, but you will, since you truly love God, and because you hear truth, you are of his flock. As this has all been promised to you, the Holy Spirit of God will dwell with you forevermore. You will be considered clean because of the word that is being spoken to you. If you believe and take this all in, then God is glorified and his angels rejoice. Blessings be upon you and all the work of your hands, that you may sprout much fruit in due season. As the golden age of Israel, all will see. As a witness to the Most High and of all of his promises as well, as the world is already watching and has known as well that this time was coming and now is very near. Let's pray. Lord God of Israel, we pray to you on this day. For the words that you have given, your remnant has received. Prayers for them and their families, for those that you have given to be your holy nation, for they are yours and they belong to you, O Lord of hosts. This prayer is for your remnant that is already here and for the ones that you will be bringing here to join us from all over the world for such a time as this in history. A very special time that you have ordained. We believe. So Lord God, sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth, that they may know you, and that they may be known by their love, and become one flock in you, no longer segregated by religious traditions of men, but instead living in the truth of your word through Messiah. We pray this to you, the only true God of the universe, the God of Israel. Hallelujah.